So yeah, morning everyone. My name is Chris Watson. I'm from Indoor Learning and Develop. Great to be with you today. So we'll get to the stage where you're going to be able to apply, without doubt, the most robust approach to understanding non-verbal communication and applied body language. The highest, the most sophisticated form of communication is this at the top of the pyramid, which is about understanding the subtleties and the nuances of both facial gestures and non-verbal communication, body language. Appropriate use of eye contact will make you come across, imagine you've got this control as well, as more open, more sincere, more persuasive, more plausible. Conversely, if you are someone who maybe feels at times they don't have good eye contact, what it's suggesting is that something that might be on the mind. The majority of the material that we're going to cover today applies to Western preferences. And that's quite important, that distinction, because there are significant variations depending upon the cultural setting. So we will acknowledge that. Even something like eye contact, we were saying improved significantly on the second version of that exercise, in an Aboriginal culture, maintaining eye contact with someone, it seems really disrespectful. So actually, you want to demonstrate your respect for someone by deferring and not maintaining eye contact. Heaps of variations. So, first of all, just to confirm, are you right or left-handed?
Right, that's great. That's the most important thing.
Tell me about yourself. I know you work at Axpro. What about, what do you like to do outside of work?
I
love
walking.
Lovely. Whereabouts are you walking?
I like
Lovely, yeah. What sort of things make you laugh?
I don't know.
Have you got any preference for comedians?
Willie Evans.
Willie Evans, right, yeah. Quite sort of animated, isn't it? Quite sort of physical. Excellent. Of all your relatives, who's got the longest hair? Your niece.
Brilliant.
Which of your feet are warmer at present?
That
one. And it's to do something called lateral eye movement. And again, there's lots of misinformation about lateral eye movements. But the reason I'm highlighting this is because actually about the subtleties of the communications that you're sending out all the time. There is misinformation about this. Some people say, oh yes, if your eyes look to the top right, that means you're lying. And this is another Cosmopolitan article, if you like, in the making for you. It doesn't mean that at all. Definitely mean it if you're left-handed, but it might indicate an area that you want to probe a little bit more. And let me show you why. The eyes particularly are the most reliable source of non-verbal information that you can glean from someone, okay? Facial expressions, the eyes themselves are the most reliable indicator. There's 90 muscles in your face, 30 of them are used exclusively for expressing emotion, to really understand what's truly going on with that person. And an appropriate amount of eye contact is a great way, great foundation for building trust and rapport. Now, an appropriate amount of eye contact isn't 100% of the time, all the time, when you're talking with someone, because actually there's quite uncomfortable for both of us, isn't it? And that, if anything, is quite aggressive. Yeah? So an appropriate amount actually tends to be about 40% of the time when we're delivering, i.e. we're conveying information, and about 70% of the time when we're listening. So it's not even 100% when we're listening either. There needs to be some sort of breakthrough in that. Here's an attractive woman, If anyone can see this clearly, I hope you can, I'm going to show you a slightly adjusted photo of her, okay? It's almost exactly the same, and I wonder, this is photo one, and that's photo two.
Her eyes are a bit brighter.
Yeah, they are here, yes. The pupils are dilated. This is really interesting. Most people know that actually, when you see something you like, your pupils involuntarily open. Okay, they actually want, your body physiologically wants more of that data or more of that information in. And that could even be in some business meeting, a performance review or whatever. You see something or you see someone you like, yeah? Even if it's in a sort of quite a bright room, your pupils will dilate more. And this is where you'll get the sort of statements like, oh, they had a twinkle in their eye, yeah? Or, you know, these sort of things about their eyes lit up when you said that. Because actually, physiologically, their eyes do light up. Because more light comes in, bounces off the back of the retina, and you actually see a glint in the eye. Here's what's really interesting, though, that's been known for quite a while, is that when you hear something you like, your pupils dilate as well. Not just when you see it. If you're a real observer of the human condition, actually, and you start sort of detaching yourself from the content of what's going on and looking at the sort of people and behaviour and non-verbal communication, you can actually sometimes even see changes in terms of people's pupils and what's happening. Is this person sad, happy, angry, surprised or fearful? It's important that you write it down. Okay? What do you think? Any offers?
Happy.
Sorry?
Happy.
Got happy? Anything else?
Sad.
Sad? Couple for sad? Any other options? Fearful? Surprised? I haven't got all the The answer, 38% of people tend to be right with this, okay? And actually there isn't a gender bias either here. So 38% of men, 38% of women are right. I'm fascinated by people who are experiencing discomfort for some reason. There's a curiosity about that. And I think part of that curiosity is driven by the fact that you do get more linkage, you get a lot more we get behaviour that's easier to spot during times of duress, and people do revert in stress when you digress, so they do revert to, you know, more authentic types. So it's a fascinating sort of area. Ladies and men, and anyone with a male partner, okay, watch out for this. This is a red flag. Were you with that woman last night at the Bird in the Barley? No, I was nowhere near the Bird in the Barley. If you get that, at that moment of response, boy, you know, probe and dig all you like, because, and this is another, it's only a male thing, I don't know if it's because women are more mindful that they might have eye makeup on or whatever, but it only happens with men. But it's a furious rub of the eye, yeah? And if it happens when you're asking a direct question, watch out.